And actually the Muslim, they learn that Shaitan, he lay eggs from who? From Muhammad, the trustworthy. He don't lie. Muhammad don't lie. He's a trustworthy. All those stories are true story. You know? Shaitan, yes, he lay eggs. Actually, me myself, I saw him. I saw him, brother. I saw him in the Middle East. He was laying eggs. Actually, some stores in the Middle East, they don't sell only like chicken eggs. They sell Shaitan eggs. They find them all over. Huh? Let us see if we can find the hadith. Here we go. The Prophet said, don't, if you can help, be the first who enter the market and the last who leave, because it is the era where Shaitan, he's a standard of Shaitan. He said, what this is? The translation is false. Let us see here, down. Where is the translation? Where is the hadith? The hadith is gone. It says here in Arabic, because Shaitan, he laid down his eggs in it. Bada Shaitan wa farrakh. Unbelievable. The translation doesn't show. They are trying to cover up. It says the Shaitan, he sat there. The hadith says the Shaitan, he sat there. You see how they lie, trying to hide the stupidity of Muhammad? In Arabic here it says, let me do this, hold on. Just to get them busted, those cowards. That's why you cannot trust Muslims explain Islam to you. No dignity. No dignity whatsoever. I will use Google to translate. Here we go. This is Google. I will use Google browser. This is their translation. Let us zoom there. Give me a second. This is the Muslim translation in the left. I will click translate and let us see what Google will do. Does it say he lay eggs or I'm making things up? All right, here we go. How come in Google it says that Shaitan, he lay eggs and those eggs, they came out? Huh? How come in Google translation there is eggs and those eggs, they have a check if the devil, but in the Muslim translation it's gone? Do you see it? The reason they change it, because this is embarrassing. Muhammad is a fool, he's a liar. This is the trustworthy. So let us make it simple. Muhammad, he marry women according to Muslims because he want to spread Islam. That's mean he's a filthy man. He's trying to use women just for the benefit of his own benefit, to be considered as a prophet so he can make verses. Says any woman, she can give herself to the prophet. The Muslim, they say the prophet, he have no benefit from this. But he will get, will Muhammad, he get the fifth of the booty? Muhammad, he made verses in the Quran, any woman she give herself to the prophet so he can F her. The prophet, he was getting the best of the booty, even women, slaves, money, the fifth of the booty. So my friend, when those liars, they try to fool you, don't give them a chance. I hope, Firoz, I'm lying. How are you, Firoz? Firoz, guys, look at this. Look at this, Abdul. Christian friend, stop lying. I'm showing you on the screen, you donkey. You know, people, they say to me, why you use the word idiot, donkey? I mean, you tell me what I would do. I'm showing in the screen, even I'm using Google Translation, which is a plain, not a, it's a software, and yet they say you're lying. I show the book number, I show the name, I show the reference, everything. Did I say anything since I started without showing reference? And then he says, stop lying. Stop lying. They have a low IQ. They think by saying stop lying, people, they will, Abdul, in order to prove me lying, well, you have to read the reference and to prove me as a lie. I'm showing you the reference. What's wrong with you? Too much hashish, brother? Honestly, aren't you taking hashish today? Did you drink camel urine? I mean, I'm showing you the reference in front of you. When you say I'm lying? Hello? This is the same guy. We showed him that he's a prophet. His prophet don't lie. That the sun set in the murky water. He says, oh, this is metaphorical. Metaphorical? The sun set in murky water is metaphorical? Metaphorical for what? What murky water metaphorical for? Soup? Hummus? Even this one is metaphorical for them. Just in order to defend their stupid prophet who got busted by us. Dr. Muhammad, he is a person who works in NASA. You know, Muhammad remind me of the previous president of Egypt. Shame is, as even this guy, he became a president of Egypt. It's a shame. The Egyptians, they deserve better. Muhammad Morsi, you know, he's from the Muslim Brotherhood. He claimed that he used to work in NASA, and NASA, they never heard of him. The guy, he don't even know how to speak two words in English. And he claimed that he worked in NASA. I work in NASA. And actually, I wish I can play for you some videos of those. Oh boy. You remind me of this guy now. Let us see. All right. Oh boy. Let us see. I found the video. Okay, guys, they ask the president of Egypt. It's a conference. He's a president now. I mean, what you can do? So they ask him like a question about this is, and his name is Muhammad. Exactly. They ask him a question, and now he's going to explain.
Versus حضارات أخرى وليس أجنس versus حضارات أخرى وليس أجنس.
Have you ever heard of such an English? One word in English, two words in Arabic. versus حضارات أخرى.
Civilization versus another one. Not against another.
And those are the Egyptians making fun of such a president. And then things get complicated. So like he starts answering now serious questions. I mean, the guy is genius like the prophet.
Drunk. يتمسك يروح السجن إذا كان driving.
And supposedly he's speaking English now. He's saying to them, isn't it supposedly if somebody is drunk, he go to jail if he's driving? But he's speaking Arabic and he with the word drunk. And supposedly all, nobody speak Arabic in the conference. And supposedly everybody know he understand what he's saying. Oh boy. Oh man.
What? انت بتقول دولار يا راجل قول
قول قول
يعني gas and alcohol don't mix مش ده قانون
And look, everybody is laughing at this stupid idiot who is trying to supposedly make a speech of a president. That is Muhammad. This is what happened to Muhammad in his time. People, they were dying and laughing at him. Nobody believed in such a garbage, stupidity. This is what happened when Muhammad, he says, if any woman, she want to have mut'ah for 3 days, 3 nights, go have fun. Arab, they get disgusted of his stupidity and his filth. What does president have to do with Islam? Everything. This is the head of the Muslim Brotherhood in Egypt, and he is follower of the Prophet, and he is smarter than the Prophet. So if he is educated Muhammadan, he speak like this. What about Muhammad? What about your Prophet? Firoz, you know what? What does have to do with your Prophet? Nothing. Your Prophet is way more disgusting and stupid, man. Okay, let me show you an example. Firoz, you are a smart person and you are very educated. I noticed that. I want you to explain this to me. And I think you are the only one is capable of explaining this. Why you think your prophet, he said, that if a woman have orgasm first, the baby will look like the mother, a female, and if the man have orgasm first, the baby will look like the father? Firoz, do you agree with your prophet, or this is metaphor? Firoz, is that metaphor? If the man have orgasm first, the baby will look like the father? Do you understand now? So the president of Egypt, he is way better than your prophet. At least he just said, man, you cannot mix alcohol with what? With gas. Unbelievable. This is your prophet. This is your prophet, the fool. Explain to us, is that metaphor? Or this is a fraud, a liar who is making things up? Firoz, take my advice. You know what, Firoz? I'm not worried about your wife having orgasm first, because none of the wives of the Prophet were able to have orgasm. And you Muslim women don't have orgasm because you do circumcision for them. Don't you? Right? Why you don't debate him? Did you hear about Indonesian Bahar bin Smith, he escaped prison? My friend, you are mentioning to me names I never heard of. And who said I don't debate with him? Bring him to me to debate me. What I can do? Why you don't debate with him? What do you want me to do? Go in front of his house in Indonesia? Why you don't debate with him? I mean, people, they say things which are really funny, hilarious. Firoz, are you there? Firoz, are you there? I don't know. I mean, you're a prophet. Obviously, he don't tell lies. You know, and actually we just discovered that all the diseases can be fixed with one seed. Dr. Muhammad, he discovered that. See the connection between this guy? This guy, his name is Dr. Muhammad Mursi, and Muhammad, your prophet, is Dr. Muhammad. He knew the biology, he knew medicine, he knew everything. The Najd seed is remedy for every disease. Firoz, take this seed, trust me, you will be smart. And your problem will be solved. You will not speak like a fool no more. I want you from tomorrow morning, the first thing you do, you go and buy the seed. Don't take too many of it, because then you will become genius. All right? Just one, brother. Not too many. Be careful. Because this Najd seed, we need to provide it to all mankind. That's it. Nobody will get sick anymore. This Najd seed remedy for every disease except death. Muhammad the fool, he considered even death is a disease. This death is a disease. Hmm. Anyway, so guys, when they say to us Muhammad was not a person after lost, Muhammad was the lost itself. Muhammad even, he allowed Muslims just for fun to rent Muslim women and do mut'ah. 3 days, 3 nights. There's no orgasm word in the translation? Really? No, there is. It says here, guys, there's no orgasm word in the Muslim. Smart. There is no, no, there is. It says, who comes first. So what comes first mean? Guys, there is no orgasm in the translation. What comes first mean? Firoz, genius. There's no organization. There is no orgasm there. Okay, comes first where? Maybe come first to school. Maybe comes first inside the room. Genius and stupid to death. Unbelievable. Thank God you are not my neighbor. And thank God you are not from my family. There's one thing I fear, is to live with a stupid person. I cannot take it. Firoz, I'm not going to talk to you. You are just a kid, Abdul. Come on. I want an adult, my friend. It doesn't say orgasm there. It says whoever comes first. What does that mean? Your prophet saying, you idiot. The man water is thick and white. And you are saying, where is orgasm? So what is the man water, which is white, if it's not orgasm? Let me guess. It's Pepsi Cola. Oh, no, this is ice cream. You obviously, the prophet is not talking about orgasm. He said the man water is thick and white. Where is orgasm? Christian Prince. Hello, Christian Prince. And now Christian Prince, you do not know what to say. Obviously, it doesn't say orgasm. The prophet, he just said, the water of the man is thick and white. So where is orgasm? And the prophet says, and the water of the woman is thin and yellow. So when is orgasm? And whichever of them comes first, the child will resemble the parent. So where is orgasm? There's no orgasm. Firoz, you want to talk to me? Are you sure? What is orgasm? I don't see the word orgasm. Anyone notice the word orgasm? Anyone notice anything to do with orgasm here? I mean, Christian Prince obviously is lying. Nowhere in the hadith, brother, it says the word orgasm. Do you see the word orgasm? Brother, I don't see orgasm. You are right, I don't see orgasm. Or what it says here, that the man water is thick and white. Brother, what is that water which is thick and white? Brother, let me explain to you, brother. As an example, brother, when you blow your nose, what comes from your nose? Water. Exactly, brother. And what it is, sometimes it's like disgusting. Thick and white. Exactly, brother. That is a liquid come from your nose. Because we Muslims, we have orgasm from our nose. I mean, stupidity is amazing, man. If this is not about orgasm, this is about what? He was making hummus? This is metaphorical, maybe. This is metaphorical water which is white. Actually, you know, your prophet, he say a lot of things about those things which is drive you crazy. If I would start to quote him for you, you would go crazy, man. As an example, your prophet, he promised you in the heaven that if you wish to have a baby, you are going to be get a bread net and you will deliver it in less than 15 minutes. But how you can do that? You're a man. From where the baby will come? Look at the first translation here, man. That first translation is amazing. What is this? Little good name busted in different translation. The prophet said, the messenger of Allah said, the believer when he desire a child in paradise, he shall carry him. Firoz is going to have a big belly. He's a bright net. And he, the child, will be born and complete, and he will have teeth and mustache in less than an hour. By the way, the word hour here is not correct translation. Yes, in Arabic it says hour, but hour in Arabic at that time means 15 to 20 minutes. Sa'a. So Muhammad promised you, Firoz, that you will have a child and you will deliver him, but he did not say where he will come out from. Do you have any idea, Firoz, where the baby come from? Let us think about it. He will come from your belly button, or he will come from your nose, or he will come from your ears. Okay, I'm out of, what is that? If there's any hole left we did not mention. Unbelievable. Firoz, is that metaphorical? Brother?
Oh boy.
Oh, Lord have mercy. All right, guys. I think we have enough for today. Did we have a good time? Don't forget to subscribe and later unsubscribe, because if you subscribe and unsubscribe, Allah will give you blessing. For if you subscribe to a Christian prince, Allah will be upset. But if you unsubscribe, Allah will give you double reward. So think about it. Subscribe, Allah will not give you reward. Unsubscribe, He will give you double reward. That is mean you will win a lot of reward. Genius God. Genius God. What do you want more? Huh? Unbelievable. You never lose with Allah, brother. I mean, everything is perfect. You go to heaven, you want to have a baby? You got the baby. How to get the baby out is a different story. By the way, do you know that Muhammad and his followers believe that a baby, a woman, she can be pregnant for more than 10 years? Do you know that? Hold on. I was going to go, but you just remind me, guys, of something. You know, if I am not showing reference, I mean, I'm showing reference, and the Muslim, they say to me, you are a liar. So imagine I am not showing reference. Just for a laugh. This is Al-Islam Su'al wa Jawab, very famous Muslim website, Islamic question and answer. Sheikh Muhammad Saleh Al-Munjid, one of the biggest sheikhs in Saudi Arabia. أطول مدة تمكثها المرأة وهي حامل. The last period a Muslim woman or a woman she can be carrying a child, a baby, pregnant. The question. I mean, the question is long, but anyway, we will go to the answer. What is the maximum of period of you know, women being pregnant? The answer is in front of you. I'm going to click translate to English. I have nothing to do with it. Firoz, you will say you're lying. Firoz, it's not me, brother. This is your scholars. Translate, please. All right. The scholars of Sharia, they differed about the maximum length of the time of the women be pregnant. So, the maximum period of pregnancy, blah, 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 9 months, and then continue. The maximum period is 1 year, which is saying the Muhammad ibn Abdul Hakam, and 2 years in the in his doctrine of tap. What tap? 3 years according to Layth ibn Sa'd, 4 years, which is the view of Shafi'i and Hanbali. Those are big Islamic Sunni sect. The Muslim Sunni sect are four sect. This is two of them, Shafi'i and Hanbali. How many years? 4 years. Okay, and Maliki. So three sect from four, they believe that a woman, she can be carrying a baby for 4 years, which means if you divorce your wife and after 4 years she gave you a baby, she call you, says come to the hospital and pay the bill. You cannot say this is not my son, because according to Muhammad garbage, the woman, she still can give a child to the same man after 4 years. Let us continue. And according to Imam Malik, 5 years in his narration from Imam Malik, 5 years, okay. 6 years, which is according to Az-Zuhri and Malik, okay. Are we going to stop? No. 7 years is according to him, Rabi' al-Rai, and another version of Az-Zuhri and Malik, okay. 7 years. And there is no limit to most brilliant saying of Abu Ubaid. No limit. No limit. If you have a wife, you divorced her 20 years ago, don't be surprised if she call you after 20 years and she said to you, husband, I'm going to the delivery room right now. Come to the hospital and pay for your son. What are you talking about? I divorced you 20 years ago. Stupid husband. I will force you to pay for him. According to Sharia law, he is your son. How is my son? I divorced you 20 years ago. All of this to cover the problem which Muhammad he created. For Muhammad was born 4 years after his father's birth. Have you ever heard of a person? He was born 4 years after his father's death. Muhammad. And this is why they speak about many years, just to cover the ass of their prophet. Now, I don't know how to shorten this page for you. Hey, hold on, let me. Who want the link? Who want the link? Anyone want the link? Okay, if you want the link, blink. Let me shorten the link for you so you guys can, I mean, you can use Google Translation, but I have to shorten it first because it's an the title have Arabic and Google don't allow that. Link shorten. Muhammad, Prophet Muhammad, brother, that's it. Amazing prophet. The Sadiq al-Amin, the trustworthy. What a scumbag. All right. This is the link for those who want it. You can use Google Translation to translate. And this is a very authentic website. And it's run by scholars. Those are not like those potato tomato in YouTube. Those are the big scholars. Al-Shaykh Muhammad Salih al-Munjid. Let me show you who is this guy. All right. Muhammad Salih al-Munjid. Give me a second. All right. This is the Sheikh who is in charge of this website, brother. And by the way, the best of their scholars is not equal even to my toes. If this guy he dared to talk to me, I will crush him the way I crush a fly. Salih al-Munjid. And actually, the bigger they get, the easier to break them, because you see, people, they know them, they are famous and they have a big job. So if you when they lie, is going to be a big problem for them, you know. Not like those on YouTube, they can say whatever they want, you know. You say to them, Allah have a leg, they say, who says so? This guy, he cannot say that. You say, yes, Allah have a leg, Allah have a foot, you know. Not like those kids, Allah have a shin, or who says that? It doesn't say that, CP. All right, sorry guys, I got to say something. Abbas, you want to call me Abbas? I'm sure people, they will be, we need some entertainment for this morning. Okay, Abbas. I am in Skype, Abbas. Call me, Abbas. Are you there, Abbas? Okay, let me search for him. All right, let us call Abbas just for a laugh. Abbas, are you online? What happened to you, Abbas? Abbas is not online. He wanna call me, but he's not online. Abbas is not online. Brave Abbas. Firoz, Firoz is saying to me, stop calling fake Muslim. Are you a fake Muslim, Firoz? Okay, let us call Firoz, as long as Abbas is a fake Muslim. Answer, Firoz. You asked for it. Answer, Firoz. Hey Firoz, you are the real Muslim supposedly?
Hello?
Hello, hello Firoz. Are you the real Muslim?
Yes, I'm a Muslim.
No, are you real Muslim? Are you real Muslim? Are you real Muslim?
What do you mean, are you real Muslim?
Okay, do you beat your wife?
No.
Why you don't beat your wife?
The
question is, if you are a real Muslim, don't you follow the Quran? The Quran says to beat your wife. Do you beat your wife?
I know that verse. Hello?
Yeah, I'm listening.
Yeah.
Hello, are you going to spend the whole day saying to me, hi, hello? We got it, hello. I'm asking you, do you beat your wife? The Quran says in chapter 4, verse 34, beat your wife. Are you Muslim? Are you willing to follow the Quran? If your wife, you ask her to make some coffee for you, and she said no, are you willing to beat her and follow Allah? Don't say to me hello again. Don't say to me hello, do you hear me? I hear you, and there's no need for more hello. Now answer, do you beat your wife as the Quran said?
Can I give you a Bible verse?
You can give me anything you want. You are a Muslim. You don't follow the Bible. You follow the Quran. So do you change your religion now?
No. I'm going to play the same game like you.
No problem. You can play any game you wish. First answer the question. Do you follow Muhammad and beat your wife? Yes or no?
No, I don't beat my wife. So
are you saying beating your wife is wrong?
Let me give you a verse.
No, are you saying beating your wife is wrong?
Yes, it is wrong.
Okay, so why now, Allah allow you to so why Allah allow you to beat your wife as long as it's wrong?
I can give you give the same verse from Bible.
No, you cannot give me the same verse. No, no, no. There's no same verse, and the Bible says you can beat your wife, you are a liar, and I challenge you. But before you go anywhere, answer me. You just said, everybody heard you, that beating the wife is wrong, and I agree with you. That means Allah is not a God. You just said Allah is wrong, everybody heard you. And you are the one who claimed that you are the real Muslim.
I'm a Muslim.
Okay, but you just said beating wife is wrong. Everybody heard you. Does it say in the Quran that beat your wife if you fear their rebellion? It says that.
Is there a verse in Bible where it says kill women and children?
Here we go. He will change. This is in the this is war time, my friend. This is war time. What does it have to do with the wife? What does it have to do with the wife? Answer. You just said, you admitted that beating wife is wrong. Allah is teaching you wrong. Is it wrong or not?
It is wrong. See, thing is that women also do a lot of mistakes, right?
But you said already, you agreed. We do not need to discuss it. You agreed that women are beating women is wrong. So why Allah, he says to do wrong if beating women is wrong? What kind of God he teach you wrong? And you are the one who says it's wrong.
Hello.
Hello. Hello. Hey. Hello. Yeah. Hello. Hello. Yeah. Gather some thought. Hello. Hello. Do you hear me? Hello. Hello. How many times you said to me, hello, how are? So all this time you are, you know, that don't recall Muslim, fake Muslims. So supposedly you are the real Muslim. And in 2 seconds, we discover you are not a real Muslim. You are not willing to follow the Quran. What kind of a real Muslim? He is not following his God teaching. And he says it's wrong.
You and me, we both agree in Bible and in...
No, I agree with the Bible. No, I agree with the Bible. I agree with the Bible. It's you who don't agree. I just showed you a verse. It says you don't agree with it. You are the one who don't agree.
When I say I never said I don't agree.
You just say that beating women is wrong. You just say beating women are wrong. And the Quran says beat your wife. So you just admitted that Quran is wrong.
It's okay. Hello.
Hello. Okay, get lost, man. Hello, hi. You spend the whole day hello. Because he has nothing to say. Hello, hi. Hello, hello. Yeah, hello. Hello. Stupid idiot. Where is Abbas? Abbas is better than you. At least Abbas, he say only hello once. Let us call Abbas again. Abbas, are you there, Abbas? That is the real comedia, you know. And the funny, when they say to me, you call only stupid Muslims. Okay, where is the smart one? Where is it, my fault? Yes, Fifi, how are you? Go ahead.
Hello.
Yes, Fifi, go ahead.
Hello.
Yes, go ahead, Fifi. Here we go. Another smart person. Go ahead.
Yeah, I have a question for you, so I want you to answer me, okay? I will ask you right now.
Okay, ask me right now.
So, I was watching one of your videos, and you told me that, Kaaba is like pagan origin. Can you show me the proof?
Can you show me the proof? Yeah, for sure. It's very easy. Okay. If we go right now and we check, do you Muslims, and I think you are from India, don't you Muslims believe that Allah, he sent Adam to India? Sri Lanka specifically?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Isn't this where the Hindu is coming from? So why Adam is coming from Sri Lanka? What is the connection between Sri Lanka and Islam? And why Allah, he land Adam in Sri Lanka? Do you think Allah, he land Adam? Do you think Allah, he land Adam in the wrong place? Or it was a chosen place by Allah?
This is not my question.
This is not your question. We are coming in the question. Here we go. So the first thing, Adam was an Indian guy from Sri Lanka. That is the root of Islam based on this. Secondly, the black stone in the Kaaba, which your prophet, he said, that if you touch it, that will erase your sin. Is that the same stone the Hindus, they have, which is a sexual stone?
Not every black stone is the same, you know.
No, it is the same. Here we go. Okay, let me ask you. I'm asking you. Was the Arab used to go around the Kaaba totally naked?
What?
Was the Arab used to go around the Kaaba totally naked?
Where did you get this from?
Here we go. This is Sahih Muslim in front of you. It says, narrated that the Arab, they used to go around the Kaaba, circumambulate around the Kaaba, naked. You see? Okay. What is the religion was a practice there where people, they go, women and men, they go around the Kaaba naked. And why they are naked?
Give me the link.
Here we go. I will post the link for you. Here we go. Let me post the link. And this is Sahih Muslim. This is Sahih, authentic. You cannot say it is weak. So now I need your help. What was the religion practice at that time where people go around the Kaaba naked? What do you think? Why they are naked?
I didn't receive the link. Wait. Okay. Wait.
The link is in the chat.
So is this Sahih or?
No, this is Da'if.
No, sorry. I'm I don't accept the Da'if one. Hey, already know that.
Okay, you don't accept Da'if? Okay, we don't.
Okay,
here we go. He don't accept Da'if, guys. No, this is not Da'if. This is Sahih. I was joking with you. This is Sahih Muslim. I mean, the book name is Sahih Muslim. And you say to me, is it Da'if? The name of the book is Sahih Muslim.
On the website, you can have anything.
Don't do the same as the one before you. He have a big mouth, but he have nothing to say. He keep calling stupid, but he cannot say anything because he is a fool. He do not know what he's talking about. So, what is the religion they were practicing going around the Kaaba of Allah naked? And where was Allah all hundreds of years and people going around his house naked? Where what Allah was doing?
Wait, the link is opening. Right? So how
do
you found out that this from pagan origin?
Well, it's front of you. Okay, you tell me, this is the practice of the Kaaba before Islam, right? Okay, so who are those people who go naked around the Kaaba? What is the practice there? This is before Muhammad. Okay, so they are going, by the way, this is after Muhammad too. Muhammad, he was enjoying watching women going around the Kaaba naked. This is why one of them, she went naked and he liked her private part. So he said he want to marry her, and then she did not marry him. Showing her vagina and she was singing. According to your tafsir, does it say in the tafsir that the black stone became black because of the blood of women? Hello?
Yeah.
Okay. Wait. Does it say in the tafsir that the black stone became a black?
Became black
because of the blood of women?
Okay, so. I'm trying to open the link, but there is something wrong. It is not open.
Over everybody can open the link, guys. Is the link is open? The link I post for you. It's working. Everybody, come on. Look what Muslim. Look what Muslim proper he said. Abbas, he said Islam. He came to correct. Where is the correction? Show me one verse in the Quran says don't go around the Kaaba naked. Guys. Islam came to correct. Firoz, just you are a kid, just go. Man, I don't have time for kids. By the time you read the hadith, I will be sleeping and having 10 kids. A bunch of kids. Can't we find an adult? Abbas, can you show me the verse in the Quran that says, don't go naked around the Kaaba? As long as Islam came to correct, where we can find that verse? I mean, how horrible it is that Allah did not mention for a second to Muhammad, tell those people to stop going naked around the Kaaba. All those years Muhammad was living in Mecca, he never said that. All those years he was in the other town, Allah did not give him the verses. Why? Allah did not see people going naked? Allah have time to tell us the story of Alexander the Great. Have the time to tell us about the flying carpet of Suleiman. Have the time to tell us about the ant speaking and Suleiman hearing the speech of the ant, which is very funny and stupid because ants don't talk and they are deaf. But he have no time to tell Muhammad a verse in the Quran. Tell them to stop going naked around my house. Huh? Islam is a pagan religion for sure. And the interpretation even confirm that Muslim women are the same as the pagan. You know, pagan are Muslim and Muslim are pagan. You see, let me show you something here. If we go and read as an example this verse, Chapter 2, verse number 158. Chapter 2, verse 158. Inna Safa wal Marwa min sha'airillah. Translation. The Safa and Al Marwa from the ritual of Allah, the symbolic of Allah. Okay, what? How this happened? Let us go and read the interpretation, shall we? If we go and see the interpretation, you will see right away that this is nothing but pagan practice. Happened in the time of Muhammad, and Muhammad is nothing but pagan person. So let us go here. Your connection is not what? Not private? It says my connection not private. I don't know why I cannot open the website. It says my connection not private. This is Firoz, the kid Firoz calling again. I don't know why. Let us try again. What connection at private? Look what it says for me. Your connection at private. I'm trying to open Tafsir at Tafsir.com. Your connection not private. Okay, let's go to different Tafsir. First of all, my friend, your prophet command came too late because at the end of his life he was dying. Where was Muhammad to command this command when he was healthy and before he died? All those years he never mentioned going naked around the Kaaba, not even once in one speech. Let me go to the tafsir. Hold on, give me a second. This is the Jordanian website is not working. 2:158. All right. Let us go to Ibn Kathir. And this is the English version of Ibn Kathir, which is far away from the truth. But you will notice here that the Muslims in the time of Muhammad, they were complaining that we should not practice As-Safa and Al-Marwa. Why? For this is the shrine of the pagan. So what Allah said to them, he said, by Allah, it is not a sin if someone did not perform tawaf around them. Okay, let's read more. Allah said to the Muslims, As-Safa and Al-Marwa are the symbol of Allah. Okay, why? So it is not sin for him who perform Hajj or Umrah around them. You know, what does that mean? Why Muslims, they thought it is sin? Let us read. Okay. It seemed that this verse was revealed concerning two groups of groups. And those are about Al-Ansar. Let us see if he will say that too. Sabi said Isaf was an idol and on As-Safa, and Naila was an idol on Al-Marwa. So there's two idols, one in As-Safa. The Safa is little hill, and Al-Marwa is little tiny hill too. And between those two, on those hills, they put one idol for a man and one idol for a woman. Supposedly those two, they have sexual intercourse inside the Kaaba. They used to touch or kiss them. After Islam came, they were hesitate and performing tawaf between them. So you see, they used to kiss them before Islam, and they used to touch them before Islam. And now Islam confirming that this is from Allah. Do you see it? It was a place of idols, one idol for a woman and one idol for a man. The man is naked, the woman is naked, because simply those about idols who they had sex in the Kaaba. And they used to go and touch them and kiss them. Who? The Arab before Islam. The Arab after Islam, they were hesitating. Should we do that? Because this is what we used to do before. Muhammad, he said, yes, this is from the ritual of Allah. Why? Because there's a group of Al-Ansar. They will not tolerate anyone to stop them. This is their belief. So Muhammad, because he is a hypocrite, he compromised. He said, okay, touch As-Safa and Marwa. It is a symbolic from Allah. Do you see it? This is what As-Safa and Marwa is. So Muhammad, this is why the verse, did you ask yourself why the verse says it's not sin to do it? Why they thought it's sin? Because it is a pagan practice. And why Allah, he need this Safa al-Marwa? You have the Kaaba already, the house of Allah supposedly. What Safa al-Marwa for? But because there's a group of people, you see, I'm trying to open the other page for this Jordanian website, but it's not working. I don't know why, you know. Let me see if there is a solution for this. Give me a second. Advanced. What is advanced is? This is my security. This is from my security. It was not allowing me. Okay. Now we knew why. Hold on. All right. Okay. Chapter 2158. No, it's open. I will wait for your screen a second. Give me a second, please. Here we go. Guys, read really carefully. This is Tafsir al-Jalalain, not Tafsir Christian Prince. It says what? It says that the pagan Arab, read carefully. This verse was revealed when the Muslim were averse this circumcision because the pagan Arab used to circumcise them, and there was an idol in the top of each mountain they used to stroke. It is reported from Ibn Abbas. See, this is a practice of the pagan. Why Muhammad? What Muhammad have to do with it? How this is became from ritual of Allah. If you go to Ibn Abbas, let us see Ibn Abbas, the cousin of Muhammad, you will see clearly that this is, okay, you know what? Let us go to the book of Asbab al-Nuzul, the reason for the verse to come down. It's even easier to understand. You will see here that the one who requested this was Al-Ansar. Al-Ansar, who they are pagan Arab, who they worship As-Safa and Al-Marwa. They refuse any command not to do practice this. And Muhammad, he cannot risk it and lose Al-Ansar. Ansar, which means the helpers. So this was revealed about a group of people from the helpers before Islam. Do you see it? Those are helpers, the Ansar. They are the one who practice this religion. They used to make a pilgrimage to go around the Manat, and they were forbidden to go between and As-Safa and Marwa. So when they join Islam, they want to do that too. They will not stop. They don't care Muhammad, he agree, he don't agree, they will not stop. So Muhammad, the filthy coward prophet, He compromised because he will not accept to lose them. He need them in his war. So he said, okay, As-Safa and Al-Marwa, it was from the shrine from of Allah, so practice it and there is no sin of it. Do you see it? Islam is very pure pagan religion. If we go in the hadith, you will see that the Muslim confirm that Muhammad was a pagan person. Why? He is the one who was one of those who carried the black stone. The Muslim, they report a story that even Muhammad, when he was young, he was carrying the holy stone of the pagan Arab. So the hadith says, let's see. We used to worship stones. And I want you to focus on me carefully here. And this is Sahih Bukhari, hadith number 4376. We used to worship stones and we use, look. We used to worship stones, and when we found a better stone, let me make the text bigger a little bit so you guys can read it better. Okay. We would throw the first one and take the later. See, always they look for better stone. But if we could not get a stone, we used to collect some earth, i.e. soil, and then bring a sheep milk and sheep it over it. And like milk it over it. And perform tawaf. Do you see the word tawaf? Do you see the word tawaf? Around it. Do you see it? So the Muslims are pagan. The same as the pagan Arab before them. Everything the Arab used to do, they carry on. The Arab used to worship stones, kiss stones, lick stones, put their hand in their vagina and put it inside the black stone. Muhammad, he carry on. They used to go naked. Until now, the Muslim, by the way, they are naked. If you go right now, if we search, let me show you. If we show you how Muslim they dress when they go to Hajj. It's a nakedness clothing presenting the Hindus. Exactly the same as the Hindus. And the same as the Buddhas. Let me show you. They are totally naked in the Kaaba, literally. Look at this. You think that those people, they just came from the shower. How this is, can be a clothes to meet your God with? Do you see it? They put a sheet around themselves. And they show the right shoulder have to be open or with the same exactly as the Hindu and as the Buddha priest. And this is where their clothes is coming from. And not only that, they shave their head when they go to do Hajj. You can go right now and search for Hindu and Buddha priest and you will see how they dress. Let us do that. Hold on. Give me a second. Now, I am not an expert in the Hindu religion. But you do not need to be a genius. Exactly the same. And the color can change depending on the location. You see, they show the right shoulder. It's just a sheet. They shave their head. And this is what Muhammad and his followers, they practice around the Kaaba. The Hindu, they have a black stone, Shiva stone. The Muslim, they have the black stone, which is a holy stone, present the vagina. Right? Yassin saying, my Bible have some polytheist legend like Allah. Well, that's your statement. Prove it. So we can laugh at you. Any Muslim have a comment? Muhammad, in the beginning of his life, he was trying to convince the Jews that he is a Jew. This is why all his life, when he was a prophet, most of it, he was praying in the direction to Jerusalem. The one who is behind going back to the roots as pagan is Umar ibn al-Khattab. Who is the one who decide where to pray for? It was Umar. Which is raise a question about who is Allah? Allah is Umar. My Lord conquered with my judgment on three occasions, in the case of the station of Abraham, in the case of observe a veil, and in the case of a prisoner of Badr. By the way, there's some hadith says 10 things, this hadith says 7 things, 5 things. So each one of them, he give you different thing. Who is the one who came with the Kaaba to be the station of Allah again? It was Umar. Islam is made by Umar, not by Muhammad. As you see in the front of your eyes. Actually, even Muhammad, he says, if there is a prophet to be after me, it will be Umar. He said that. Because Umar, he got him busted. He is stealing what Umar say. He put it in the Quran. The hijab is from Umar. The Kaaba is from Umar. The change of the wives of Muhammad from Umar. Umar is the caliphate, the companion of Muhammad. Islam is a pure pagan. You know, when Muhammad, he say, if you touch the black stone, that will erase your sin. How that can be not a pagan? Any Muslim want to explain to us how this is not a pagan practice? Touching black stones and the Yemeni corner erase your sin. Firoz saying, look, Firoz is supposed to be smart. He's saying, are you saying that the Indian, they were in the Hindus, they were in the Arabian Peninsula during the time of Muhammad? You know, Firoz, sometimes stupidity is a blessing, honestly, because it makes you feel comfortable. You are the one who called me, and you agreed that Adam came from Sri Lanka. Correct? That means, yes, according to, obviously, there was Indian coming to the Arabian Peninsula. And actually, if you look at the map, India is just a few kilometers away from Saudi Arabia. The sea between them is just a few hours in the ship. But what make it funny that Adam is coming from Sri Lanka, which is the statement of your funny prophet. Not only stupid is it proving to us the roots of Islam, but if we look at it, let us love together. Sri Lanka. Okay. This is Sri Lanka. How Adam was able to cross, because he is not in India, he is in Sri Lanka, which is part of India, yes, but I mean, now it's a different country, but it is not really connected to India. There is a sea between them. So how Allah, he sent this man Adam to Sri Lanka, and then this man Adam, he was able to go all the way to Mecca. Maybe Adam was a champion of swimming, and he was able to cross from Sri Lanka to the land. And not only that, every year, according to Muhammad, Adam, he did practice Hajj 40 times during his lifetime. So we do not know how many years. Supposedly, according to Muslim, he did more than 1,000 years. So if you say in 1,000 years he did Hajj 40 times, that will be, let us see. We use the calculator, 1,000 divided to 40. This is every 25 years. Every 25 years, Adam, he had to swim from Sri Lanka all the way to India, and then he have to go all the way to Mecca, and then he go back to Sri Lanka. I'm not going to ask you how Adam was able to find Mecca without GPS, without map. I'm not going to ask you how he crossed the sea. I'm going to ask you why Allah made him land in Sri Lanka. And by the way, Adam was landed in Sri Lanka, but anyone knows where Eve was landed? Who knows where Eve landed? Anyone remember? Just to show you the stupidity of this cult. All of it is fiction stories collected from here and there. Eve, according to some Islamic stories, she landed in Yemen. Adam was landed in Sri Lanka. Okay, how they met again? I am guessing that Adam, he sent the WhatsApp message to Eve. Hey, what's up? Where are you now? And then Eve, she sent him her location, or maybe Viber. And this is how they were able to find each other again. I mean, have you ever heard of a stupid cult like this? I am thinking in that time, maybe there was Facebook and been destroyed by the flood of Noah. Maybe, you never know. Destroyed. Now we don't have it no more. Because how Adam and Eve, they met together again? Very tough question, brother. Extremely hard to answer, you know? Yeah. Adam was what? So he could. Guys, look at the answer of Firoz. Look. This is a Muslim. He squeezed his head so hard and he come with the answer. Adam was a giant. So he could swim, throw long distance in water. Abdul, you are really stupid. If he is giant or small, that will not change how his ability to swim, because if you are a giant, it's going to take you the same effort to carry your body, because now you have a giant body. So your size will not actually, the bigger the size of your body, the harder will be for you. Stupid. I mean, look at this answer. He was giant, so he can swim. Yeah. All right, guys, I think we have good time for today. Until now, the internet, hope, is going to stay fine for later broadcast. So feel free to share it with your friends. And for sure, the video became long about this guy answering the guy. You can cut it off pieces. And always, when you download videos, try to change the title, unless there is a purpose of keeping the same title. So I want to say thank you for being here. May the Lord bless you and protect you from all lies and all evil, like Muhammad, a person who was a sex offender. Christ is Lord. Islam is false. And we prove it every day. Take care. Bye-bye. Any Muslim would like to call? Any Muslim? Who's next? Anyone? Any hero? The God who cannot have a son unless he have a girlfriend is no different from a Christian prince who have no girlfriend. He cannot have a son. The God of Mary, he can have a son without having a girlfriend. Hello?
Hello?
Yes. Hello? Yeah.
Man can be from God.
Yes. Can you introduce you? Are you a Muslim, my friend? My friend first. Are you a Muslim? Introduce yourself, please.
Hello?
Are you a Muslim?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I am a Muslim.
You are a Muslim. Okay.
Okay.
How we knew that you are a Muslim?
It's in chapter 13, verse
37. I think you are changing your voice. Doesn't make sense to me. Your voice is not real. Speak louder, please.
Chapter 13, verse 37.
Hmm. Okay. Well, I don't know. Sounds like you are a fake person. Let us see. We have the genius Firoz. Firoz is calling. This is a real Muslim. Right away, you can't tell who is a real Muslim. Firoz is a real Muslim. He's a brand new. His brain never been used. Answer, Firoz. Answer.
Hello.
Yes, Firoz. How are you, Firoz? Firoz, by the way, let me introduce you.
Hello.
Firoz. Firoz is a scientist. He has many degrees in Islam. He speak Arabic fluently, and he speak more than 400 languages except Arabic, English, French, German, etc. But he is expert in the Quran. What do you want to ask, Firoz? Go ahead.
Yeah, you showed about the words about endless private parts. So can you show me where did you find it?
I bet you did not sleep since last night because of the endless private part. I think you like the idea, aren't you? Firoz.
Yeah, show me where
I saw you yesterday.
Yes, show me.
You asking the same question, and now the first thing you come to ask for is this. Are you dreaming about it? Are you dreaming about the endless?
No, you're lying. You are lying. I never heard about this, and no one ever told about. So you're trying to make up. So I think you're lying. That is why I'm trying to ask.
All right. So if I show you the reference, what you would do?
How is it that you always find this bad stuff and we never find it?
No, I'm saying.
So there is something.
That, if I show the reference that your prophet he said that you will have a penis, which endless penis, what you would do?
Yeah, first show me.
No, I'm asking you. I will show you. Here we go. I will never hang up on you until I show you. But before I show you, I'm going to ask you. When I show you that, what you will do? I mean, you are asking me to show you. And what you will do if I show you that?
You are showing it from Sai or Tai?
My friend, we will show you. Hold on. I'm asking you now. If this is true, that you're a prophet, he promised you an endless penis. What you will do? What is next?
First show me. I know you are lying.
Okay, no problem. But
show me.
Okay,
show me.
It's a challenge. It's a challenge. But I want to know first, if this is true, what you will do?
I don't know. I will first see it and then think about it. First you show me the words.
Okay.
Where did you found it?
Well, I think you have a problem, and this is why you are asking about this question, And I think you're dreaming that your private part will increase and will become so endless. And this is, it's okay, I understand your pain. Here we go. Let us show reference, some reference. Everybody heard you saying I'm lying. And now the reference is in front of us. I will put it in the screen. And everybody will be laughing at you. In a second, I will post even the link in the chat. And everybody can see and read. Here we go. This is the book, Kitabun Nikah. All right. And let us see where the sentence it says that.
What is it?
Like, Hold on. وقد ورد يعطى أحدكم في الجنة ذكرا مثل النخل السحوق وفرجا يسع ذلك. And it's mentioned that each one of you, he will have an endless penis in heaven and the vagina will fit for that. Now you said I am lying. I want you to apologize and admit that you are a follower of a perverted prophet. And this is variant number 3, page number 356. What we will do now?
What is it? I cannot read.
Why you cannot read? Why you cannot read? Why you cannot read? Here we go. I will post the link in the chat. You cannot read, no problem. This is your problem. You know, not my problem. But you can use Google Translation. Actually, we can use Google Translation as we speak. Hold on, give me a second. Let me first post the link for anyone in the chat.
You know that.
Hold on. Here we go. This is the link in the chat. And now we are going to use Google Translation for that issue. Let us do that. Give me a second, please. Okay. Now, Google Translation, silent, Abdul. Google Translation will not be enough to explain. I mean, the translation will usually is not correct, especially if this is a classic Arabic language. But let us see. I will go, click, search. I won't translate. Translate to English. Okay. Let us see. Guys, read carefully with me. This is the Google translation, which is a city translation. It's reported that one of you in paradise will be given a meal. This is a male member. Like a palm robbed tree. This is Google translation. In Arabic, it says a sahuk, which means endless. And a vagina fit for that can accommodate it. Do you see it? So what do you say? Firoz. You challenge me to show you, and now we have the reference in the front of you. So, what you will do now?
Can you move screen to the right? I cannot see the full one.
My friend, I posted the whole link for you in the chat. You can open it from there, and you can click Google Translation. So now, what we will do? What kind of a prophet he promised you? An endless penis.
So it is a very, very long.
Suddenly, you are so quiet now. You accuse me of lying. I want you to apologize. Say, Christian prince is telling the truth, and my prophet is a liar. I am not the one who is lying. Here we go. The reference in front of you. Firoz, don't talk to yourself, talk to me. The reference in front of you, I gave it in Arabic. We use Google Translation. I want an answer. What kind of a prophet? No problem. Now, what kind of a prophet he promised you an endless penis and a huge vagina? Because imagine if the vagina will accommodate it, that's mean the vagina will be endless. That's mean the woman, she will be thick by millions of miles, because it's endless vagina, endless penis. So the penis have to accommodate it inside the vagina. So now look at what we have. We have an endless penis, and then he go inside something, and that thing is endless too. How thick the women will be? A billion mile, trillion mile? How deep her vagina? Because this is an endless penis. Are you there, Abbas? You call me liar. I apologize.
Yeah, I'm sorry, but I never heard about,
Yeah, but yeah, Firoz, each time I show you something, you say to me, first, you are a liar. Show me you're a liar. Show me you're a liar. You never learn. I mean, each time you say to me, you're a liar, I get you busted. And then you call me again and you say the same. So Firoz, would you stay as a Muslim? Do you like to have your penis endless like this? Is that your dream? Be honest with me.
How did you find this? Because, you know, this is the first time I'm saying...
Who cares? This is why I'm Christian Prince, and this is why I'm here to teach you. If I have no knowledge, why I'm here? How I find? I spend my life studying this garbage. I'm sharing my garbage with you, which is the garbage of Muhammad, in an easy way. So
it should be like...
What?
Yeah, but I will call you later. Okay.
Why you call me later? Did you decide to leave Islam now or what? Huh? He hang up. So they call me, they accuse me of lying. Then we get them busted. And then, okay, we will call you later. What happened to the guy who was excited? You want to get me busted? I mean, and you see, I'm not talking about it, but you are the one who opened this topic. And now we don't want to talk about it no more. Why? Because it's very embarrassing. Well, this is your God, and this is your prophet. Take my advice, never challenge Christian Prince. Never. You know, like, too much, like, I am not in the mood really for fun today. Usually, you know, sometimes Muslims, they challenge me and I make it like I'm looking for it. Okay, once I remember I was debating with a sheikh and he said, I challenge you to find it. And then I said, okay, can you give me time? He said, no. You know, he gets so more excited when you say to him, give me more time. I said, what about maybe tomorrow? He said, not tomorrow, today, now. He gets more excited. I said, but now it's hard to find it. He said, see, guys, I told you, see, I swear by Allah, he's lying. This guy is trying to change the topic. And I said, But brother, come on, just give me time, maybe a month, maybe I will find it in a month. And he get more excited when I said the word month. The guy, he went so crazy. He's like, he became like a bomb will explode everywhere. Allahu Akbar, he need a month to find it, blah, blah, blah. And I have it in the front of me in the screen, by the way. The idiot, if you look at the screen, it's there in front of him. Before I start saying to him, can I take a week? Can I take five? I'm just joking. But he gets so excited, he carried on. Allahu Akbar, he need a month to find it. He was lying. It's not there. He is lying to you. And then I said, hey, Abdul, take it easy. It's in the screen since 5 minutes ago, man. Read it. He said, what is in the screen? I said, the hadith, the one you are challenging me to show you. And then he hang up. I say, hello. Hello. Can you read it? Hello, are you there? Bingo. Once I was debating a Muslim, was a very hot debate. He said, I need to go to the bathroom. Just give me 2 minutes, please. I said, okay, no problem. And that was more than 10 years ago. We called the police to check on him in the because we are afraid maybe alligator, he did eat him in the toilet seat. You never know these days. A sheikh, the coward, he want to go to the bathroom. And since more than 10 years ago, he never come back. Never. All right. look, Firoz, he need more time. Guys, Firoz, he need more time to answer me. As if you have an answer. I need more time to answer. And you know, here you need to ask yourself, what kind of a prophet this prophet is, the one who promised such a promise? I mean, what does this have to do with God? I mean, if the, first of all, you have to be very savage, trashy, low-class person to speak to people in such a manner. Secondly, how that will make me believe in God, and why size does matter in Islam? The only religion size does matter is Islam. Okay, your wife, she is going to have sexual intercourse with you. Why the penis have to be endless? What about 10 meters? 20 meters? Actually, it's a penalty for any man to have a penis like this, because how you can walk with it? You see, a cat, she have a tail. She can drag it in the back if it's heavy, like the alligator. But the penis is in the front of you. You want to walk backward? How you can carry it? Is it going to walk in the ground like a snake? Endless penis? I mean, do you even have a brain? What kind of a brain this brain is? This is what happened when you start thinking, and this is what happened to this guy, the Sheikh. He started thinking about the stupidity of Muhammad, and because he, you know, it's very, like very, let us say, sad news for him to say, I'm going to be out of Islam. So he started convincing himself, no, Islam is a good religion. Allah is a true God, but the Quran is messed up. The Hadith is messed up. The Prophet is messed up. Even he agreed that the Prophet is messed up, guys. Allah is not messed up. I mean, how in the world? Because they go in denial. For the pain is so strong. Suddenly, they will have a shocking news that this is cannot be from God. This is the most stupid thing ever. Do we have any Muslim have anything to say? Don't forget, please, to subscribe, because those who subscribe to us, Allah will increase the size of your penis. Allahu Akbar. Science. And Muhammad, by the way, he is a specialist when it's come to penises, testicles. I mean, this guy, just give him the word P and he's there. A Muslim saying Christianity is a total lie. Why? Because Jesus says, be holy like your father. And Muhammad, he says, be penis like your God. If we compare between the God of the Christian and the God of the Muslims, the God of the Christian, he said, we will be holy in the heaven. We will be the same as angels, which mean pure. And we will not have sex. He said, he and she, they will not get married. They will be the same as angels, which mean our God, the holy God, in his holy house, he will have decent life for the promised people who accept him, believe in him. Your God, he is busy increasing the size of your penis in his workshop. So you go in the heaven, the second you enter, Allah now he start working in your penis. He put it in the surgery machine, and the surgery machine will make it squeeze it and keep going. I'm not going to mention the pain you will have in your penis, but Allah will make it long. And by the way, you never know, you might be a billionaire from this penis, because you can sign contract with many cable companies to run internet through the galaxy. Like internet cable, or maybe for oil. Like, you know, they spend billions of dollars to run oil or gas between two countries. By having your penis, we save it, it's for free. We just put the gas in your penis and your testicles and they will appear in Germany. Alhamdulillah. Very convincing. Allah is God. I'm just convinced now. That's it. Right? Oh, you know what? I have another idea. We can use your penis as a chimney. So we can get rid of all the bad carbon in the earth, so for a global warming. So what we do? We make fire in the place, all a chimney for all the manufacturer in the world. And then we put in the top of it your penis. And because your penis is in this, I mean, you can imagine where the gas will go. We'll never see it again. Here we go. It's a useful penis. Alhamdulillah. God, I mean, this is God. This is God talking. I mean, obviously Muhammad is a prophet. What are you talking about? There is no way. Just to show you how Muslims, even when they try to refute us, they say things that's stupid. Look, let me show you an example. This guy Abdul, he said, the Christian, they pray for a dead God. Okay, aren't you Muslims believe that Jesus is alive? And the Bible teach that Jesus is alive. So why you are lying? Why you are a potato? Neither you Muslims, neither us Christians believe that Jesus is dead. So look how stupid you are. Very embarrassing. But I think because your endless penis is functioning, not your brain, you said such a statement. I think this statement is coming from your penis. See, you see how silly? That God. What, we're Christian, we don't believe in Jesus. Actually, according to Islam, Jesus must be God. Because if you are saying that the one who died, he cannot be God, will you just confirm that Islam believed that Jesus is God? For until now, he never died in Islam. You see what I'm saying? I remember once a Muslim, you know, those Muslims, when they see a Christian, they cannot keep their mouth shut. So he supposedly, he's like, maybe he's watching too much YouTube. He said, how, you know, and there's a guy sitting, we're taking dinner. There's an old guy with him. Both of them, they are Egyptian. The other guy, he's a Muslim too. He told him, don't go there. You want to talk about religion. The other guy told him, don't go there, because he sat with me before. He told him, don't go there. In front of me, he told him that loud, don't go there. The guy, no, he said, it's just a question, you know. I said, I'm sure you don't mind. I said, okay, no problem, go ask me. So he said to me, well, if Jesus is son of God, shouldn't his father save him? And that will make him really God? I said, well, this is a really great question. If Jesus is the son of God, his father, he should save him. All right. The guy, he get happy, excited. Oof. This Christian guy, he agreed. I said, but you know what? This is mean that Jesus must be God in Islam. He said, why? I said, well, his father in Islam saved him. How stupid. I mean, stupidity is amazing. Because if Jesus, to prove that he is a son of God, then his father should save him. Well, in the Quran it says that Allah, he saved Jesus. That means he is son of God. The other guy, the elder, he said to him, see, I told you, don't go there. Answer him now. Go, answer him. Answer him. And the guy starts looking around, you know, like, has changed the topic. Oh boy, don't go there. Trust me, don't go there. You can debate those who have no idea. You can play, you can lie, you can fabricate. Here we smash you with no mercy. No mercy with liars. Until now, we never saw someone call me. He was able to prove a point. In the top of that, either he leaves Islam or he gets smashed. So let's see now, Firoz, how long is going to take him before he leaves Islam? Right? Any Muslim have anything to say? Any Muslim? By the way, in the third part of the night, yesterday, I saw Allah descending from heaven. And then I looked, it was a helicopter. This is not Allah. I was really disappointed. In the third part of the night, Allah, he come down every night. Which night? Your God, he think the earth is flat. So he think there's only one time zone. And he come every third of a part of the night. Because if this is true, that means Allah never leave the earth. Never leave the zone of the earth. Because there's many times, what was third part of the night? That it changed from town to town, from city to city, from territory to territory. I feel sorry for Allah. He keep going up, down, up, down, up, down. Hey Allah, where are you going? To the third. Now it's the third time of the night in New Zealand. Now the third time in Australia. Now it's the third part of the night in Mississippi. Now the third time in Missouri. Now the third time of the night in Canada. What is that? I feel sorry for this God. Keep going up and down, keep up in the what? And all of this to say, who is calling me? What a silly God. So you need to come down from the seven heaven to say who's calling me. Why? You cannot hear them from there. Your reception is bad like my internet. Allah reception is bad. So he go down. Who is calling me? Hello? Yeah. Any Abdul have anything to say? Mayday, last call. Any Abdul have something to say? Yeah, we got them busted, those milestone. You know, they are paid by Muslims, obviously. We got them busted. We have many videos about them. Fardeen Islam wanted to call me. Okay, why he don't call me? My Skype is open. What Fardeen Islam wanna call me? Why he's not calling? The last one who called us was Firoz, and Firoz now is calling back. Hey, Firoz.
Hello.
Yes, Firoz, what happened?
Yeah, just nothing. I will have to say sorry about that, but yeah, I mean, that's it.
So what, Firoz, did you decide to leave Islam, my friend? Firoz? He called to say I'm sorry. He apologized. That's a good sign. He noticed that when they accuse me of lying, it's not true. That's a good sign. But did you leave Islam, Firoz? Why you hang up? Maybe Firoz decided to leave Islam. That's what we're going for. This guy, each time he come here, he accused me of lying. Liar, liar. I challenge you. Lying. Firoz, call me back. I want to hear what happened. Did you leave Islam, my friend? You sound like very, yeah, he sent me a text, says, okay, I agree. So Firoz, what now? You agree? Okay. So Islam is stupid, right? Call me and leave Islam, my friend. Firoz, call me and leave this cult, my friend. You are smarter than this garbage. What this? This is God. Imagine I am standing in the street right now speaking to you. But I don't know where are you from, Pakistan, I don't know. And then I say to you, if you believe in my God will give you endless penis, you would die laughing at me. So why you don't call my friend and say I am out of the garbage of Islam? I respect you for agreeing that this is the truth. You know, actually I felt that this guy, that's, it's a waste of to talk to him. Because always he call me names, and you know, and it's a waste of time to talk to him. But you know, the Lord, he can open eyes of people, not me. Call, Firoz, call. Call and denounce the devil, my friend. It's time to denounce the devil Muhammad and his teaching. This is the devil. There is no way God Almighty, he will teach such a teaching. That is not from God. Period. Shall we try to call Firoz? Maybe the Lord, he will touch his heart and he decide to leave Islam. Let us call him. Oh, he's not going to answer now. So he's going through a situation now. Okay, I understand, Firoz. Don't answer. No problem. He hang up. I understand, that's mean he's going through suffering. If I am him, I will do the same. You believe in God, you pray for him five times a day, and then you discover this God is a pimp. It's not easy. It's not easy. I feel for him. Pray for our friend here, Firoz, that he will see the truth and the truth will set him free. Pray for him, for himself, for his family, that the Lord will open his eyes and he will leave the garbage of Muhammad. Be brave, Firoz, be brave, be a man. Life, you know, we live in this earth once. Then either we go to hell with Muhammad or we go to heaven with the Lord, the Messiah, the living Messiah. The living Messiah, remember this word, how powerful it is. The living. How in the world I want to follow the dead Muhammad who did everything wrong in the book of God? His ethic was bad, his teaching is bad, he himself was bad, and he was ugly in his behavior. Instead of following the Messiah who did nothing wrong, wonderful person, wonderful loving person, who taught nothing but love, who is now alive in your belief and in my belief. How in the world I want to leave the Messiah? I will never do so over my dead body. I prefer to die, I prefer to burn, I prefer to go do anything with me, but I will never deny my Lord. We love the Muslims, we love all mankind. For God, he loved the world, he sent his only begotten son, the world, not the white, not the black, not the Asian, not the Muslim, not the Christian, not the Hindu. All the world is beloved by God. If you are a Hindu, the Lord, he love you. If you are a Muslim, the Lord, he love you. That doesn't mean you are right. He opened the door for you if you believe in him. Otherwise, you don't belong to his house. So we invite all people to knock at the door. The Lord, he says, knock at my door and I will open for you. The Lord, the Messiah, is inviting you to join him. All what you need to do, knock and I will open. You see how simple it is? Knock and I will open. God do not need debates. They do not need even science. That is a silly argument to prove to me that God was science, because God is above science. It's impossible for science to understand how Jesus can make the blind see. It's impossible for science to explain how Mary, she can have a son without a father. It's impossible for science to say, okay, the person was dead and then he raised him from death. All of this have nothing to do with science. So either we believe in the Almighty God, and he is almighty, for he himself is a miracle, and that is Jesus. You see, all miracles happen done by prophets. They themselves, they never was the miracle except Jesus. Jesus, he himself is the miracle. Moses did miracle, but he is not the miracle. God gave him power, he did miracle for him. In the case of the Messiah, he is the miracle, for God is a miracle. His ability, his power, his ethic is a miracle. How I can be like God? I cannot. How I can have ethic like God? I cannot. How I can be loving like God? It's impossible for me. Yet he says, be holy like your Father. You see how high the project is? How high the requirement of Christ? He don't want people to say Shahada and you go to heaven, for this is a fraud. He don't accept hypocrisy. This is why he said, not everyone says to me, Lord, Lord, will enter the kingdom of my Father, but the one who do his will. So you want to be with the Messiah? Do the will, not say Shahada. God is not a fool. You cannot fool God. He do not need someone to say, I witness God is one and Muhammad is a prophet, and then you go to heaven. That is a fraud. Because what that have to do with you going to heaven unless you do what God say? And how you can be following God and you go have sex with the children? And how you can be with God and you are killing and raping and stealing? To be with God is to be the same as God wanted you to be. Imagine the Muslim, when they enter the mosque, they take off their shoes. Why? They say the shoes are dirty. Wonderful. So how you enter the mosque without shoe? Because the mosque is the house of God, but you are going to enter heaven with endless penis. And women there, they're, excuse my language, they have no panties. And all what you do, dahman, dahman, pushing hard. So the shoes is a problem for you, but you having sex 24 hours, 7 days a week, non-stop, having orgasm in the house of God is okay. Do you see the double stupid standard? So they take off their shoes in the house of God, which is just a building, not really a real house. But yet when you go to the real house of God in heaven, you are going to do what you do? How that can be? How I can be sitting in the house of God with no shame, and this God, he is happy. He provided me women I never met. You see, God created Adam and Eve. So if God, he says, okay, I will give you Eve like Adam. I understand a woman, she loved me, I love her. That's wonderful. But God, who created women just for sex, women I never met. And all of them, they have the same look, which is very funny and stupid. Imagine you enter a dating website. And all the women in this dating website, they have the same face. And they have the same name. Their name is Hur. And all of them, they have transparent skin. You can see through the marrow of their bones. I mean, how silly. Because if you have 1 million of them, or one, it's the same. You are still seeing one woman. They have the same face, same look. And all the men, by the way, in heaven, they will look the same too. All of them, they will look like Joseph. Actually, I remember once. I was doing a seminar in the Philippines. So we were playing the video. It's called Description of Paradise, if you remember. And the Sheikh, he was saying, everybody, brother, in the heaven of Allah will look like Joseph. Everybody, brother. And the funny, there was a guy between those who they are. He's a Christian, but he's funny. You know, he don't mind to, like, let us say, joke about himself. He stood up. He says, by the way, my name is Jesus, as Joseph. They will look like me. The guy, he have no teeth, but he's very full of sense of humor. He have no teeth. I mean, he looked really funny. God bless him. I'm not making fun, but he was the like, he was like, really? My name is Joseph. They will look like me, you know? So, and people die laughing. So all men, they will look like Joseph. All women, they will look like the whore. And if you have a billion women, all of them, they have the same face, the same name, and even they say the same song. Even they have a song. If you have my book, Says on Allah, you will see that. So what the point of this woman? Having 10 women in your house, all of them, they have the same name, they have the same face, the same eye, the same height, and they speak the same language and the same words. They don't even speak extra words. Like, they are programmed like toys. And all of us, we will look like Joseph. So imagine you enter a dating website, and then everybody, every profile have the same age, the same description, and the same face, and the same lips, and the same height, the same for the men and the women. This is how silly, how stupid it is. Be vigilant, be smart, be intelligent. Otherwise, the devil, he will not hesitate to make fun of you if you are stupid. And again, I repeat, if a fool like Muhammad can fool you, how fool are you? I'm not going to say how foolish, I will say how fool, because foolish is an act. Fool is you being a fool. Even it's more correct in English to say foolish, right? But I will say, how fool are you? Because you adopted foolishness, and now you are the fool. Not only you are doing foolishness, you are the fool. You embrace foolishness. So I want to say thank you all for being here. May the Lord bless you. And soon we are going to publish a few books for free. And one of them is The Deception of Allah in the Indonesian language. Very soon is going to be out for free. All right. So thank you. May the Lord bless you. And may the Lord save you all from the evil and evildoers. Doesn't matter who they are. Love the Muslims. We love the Hindus, we love the Buddhas, we love the atheists, but the question is, do they want that love? Do they love the Lord as he loved them? That is dependent on you, and it's your choice. Christ is Lord. Islam is false. And we see you soon again. Bye-bye. Should we talk about Allah the scientist? Or about Allah promised us virgin? Or about Allah promised us boys? Horny boys. Chapter 52, verse number 24. Is that a shameful behavior of someone claimed to be holy to promise me in heaven 80,000 little boys who they are very white, because no black is allowed to be in heaven, and those boys are very pretty? Is that a shameful behavior to have a slavery of boys, or it's not? And what those boys will do to me exactly, and why they are 80,000 at least? This is the lowest reward, 80,000 boys. Hey, Firoz, how are you? I heard that you left Islam, my friend. Do you want to call me and tell me about it? Firoz, he used to keep calling me liar, 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 liar. And I heard now he left Islam. Good for you. So that is God. This is not shameful. It's not shameful that God will take the wife of Pharaoh and the mother of Mary and give it to Muhammad so he can sleep with her. This is not shameful. Did that? What do you think if somebody says to you, Allah will give your mother to Christian prince? Is that shameful promise? Is it or not? Coward. Okay, let's take one call only from Firoz. Let me open my Skype, Firoz, for you. Okay. Let us see, where is Firoz? I was going to block you, by the way, because I give up with you. Text me, Firoz. I don't see you. Yeah, when you are, if you are in YouTube, in the Skype, text me, please. So you see, you know, when the Muslim, they speak about shameful, isn't it shameful to promise me little girls to sleep with? Isn't it shameful to have sex with a child she is 6 years old? A Muslim speak about shameful. Isn't it shameful that you are allowed to rent your daughter 3 days, 3 nights to somebody and get paid? Not to rent, like to, let's say, employment to work and to clean. We said Firoz, Firoz called me, only Firoz. Who is this guy calling? Hello?
Hello?
Yes, this is you, Firoz?
Yes.
Oh, Firoz, how are you doing, my friend?
Yeah, I'm doing good.
So I see even a change in your voice. What happened? You used to be angry from me and you call me so angry, and now you sound like different.
Yeah, it was very annoying actually. I used to see your videos and used to mock our religion a lot. So yeah.
Yeah, but you see, like, I notice, I don't know if people notice, guys, that Firoz's voice changed. I mean, I'm not saying the voice, I mean the tone, the way he used to talk. He was angry, upset, he hated me. Now I see peace in his voice. I see something different. Is that true, Firoz?
Yeah, actually, yes.
So Firoz, why you decide to leave Islam? I mean, you call me liar, prove it. You are a liar, that's not true. So for how long, how many times you call me liar? How many times you did that?
it like many times. I can't even count it.
Maybe how to count, right? Maybe 30, maybe 50. I don't know how many times you call me. You call me to call me liar. And what do you think?
Yeah.
Why at that time you were calling me liar?
I don't know. It was hard to accept all the things you were saying. So it was not comfortable actually.
Yeah, so it's just because it's hard to accept.
All the things that I listened is like I was listening it for the first time. I never listened it before. Seeing your videos, I never knew about these things. And for the first time hearing it from you, like it was like obviously you must be lying. So
yeah, first time you heard me, it was very harmful for you. Like you were so upset, right?
Yeah.
And did you think at that time that I hate you? Like, you know, I'm speaking obviously. Maybe I hate Muslims. Maybe you thought this way.
Yeah, obviously.
What do you think now? Do you think really I hate Muslims or I love them?
No, actually, now I know that you are speaking the truth, but at that time it was not like that.
Yeah, but now you know for sure that we love Muslims, we don't hate them. Otherwise, you know, you see, if I hate you, why I want to spend my time to show you and explain to you? I mean, life is short. Why I want to spend my time answering Firoz, showing Firoz, if I hate Firoz, you know, I don't care. Firoz, you go to hell, go to hell if I hate you, right? But because we care for the Muslims and we love the Muslims, we are trying to help the Muslims. And now here, we notice that after some time, you check everything I say and you notice this is true and you decide to leave Islam.
Yeah, right. It was very hard to accept it, but I was doing my research and I found that everything you were saying was right, true. So
Firoz, did you accept the Messiah as your savior?
Yes, I did.
I mean to that, hallelujah! We are so happy for you. So now you believe that the Messiah is your Lord and your savior, and Muhammad is a false prophet, correct?
Yeah, I accept.
That's wonderful, my friend. What about your family now? Did your family learn that you left Islam?
Them yet, but I will tell them in future.
All right. What if you need?
No, I'm not having that much confidence to tell them the truth.
Oh, be confident, be strong. Don't worry. And if you need my help, you want them to call me and speak to me, I will be happy to help them so they can leave Islam too.
Sure, sir. I will let them know.
Yeah. Well, I'm happy for you, Firoz. Even though you were calling me liar many times, but here we go. Welcome to the club of the saved one.
Sorry about it, sir.
I'm happy for you. Look how many people here, they are happy for you, Firoz. And look how many people, they are so excited that a soul was saved. The Bible says, happiness will be in the kingdom of God for one soul is being saved. So your soul, my friend, is priceless. You are not just a human for God. You are a child of God according to the Bible. So you are not a slave of Allah no more. You are a free man. And you are not only a free man. You are free by the Lord and you are a child of God. Imagine the difference. The Quran says, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْإِنسَ وَالْجِنِ إِلَّا لَيَعْبُدُونَ. I did not create genie and mankind except to worship. Our God don't want that. He don't need worshippers. He love you. Even though he is your God. He created you and he wanted to share his glory with you, for he loves you. God do not need slaves. God do not need worshippers. Your worship will not bring any good to God, but God who loves you, he wants you to be with him in his house, in his kingdom. It's all about love, my friend. God who need worshippers is not God. God who is lonely, he need people to pray. Do you remember the hadith where it says, Muhammad, he said, if you don't commit sin, Allah will destroy you and bring people who commit sin. You remember it?
Yeah, it was like related to destiny, right? It was destined to sin.
Right.
Not
but what kind of...
Someone else.
Yeah, but you notice here, this hadith proved to us that Muhammad is a fraud. Because what kind of God, he wants you to commit sin, and the purpose is what? Just because he wants you to beg for forgiveness. I mean, look at this hadith in the front of us on the screen, guys. By him, Muhammad saying, by him who has handed my life, If you were not to commit sin, Allah would sweep you out of existence, and He would replace you by those who would commit sin and seek forgiveness from Allah. This God is a filthy creature, and He is lonely, and He enjoys destruction, and He enjoys slavery. Because you see, if you don't commit sin, what He will do? He will destroy you. But this is against the teaching of God. God don't want us to commit sin, supposedly. God, He sent His prophet, so we will not commit sin. So how come if you don't commit sin, Allah will kill you? Because the purpose of your existence is to seek and to beg. He want beggars. He want people, oh, God, forgive me, I commit sin. If you don't do that, He's not happy. This is kind of a kind of illness. If you go to a doctor and see somebody is doing that to you, like, you know, he wants you to be wrong, and then he enjoy you asking for forgiveness. That is a physiology illness. A person who is sick, who enjoy seeing somebody is wrong, asking for forgiveness. So if you are not wrong, Allah will kill you. If you are not committing sin, Allah will destroy you. So why He will destroy you? Because if you don't commit sin, you will not need His forgiveness. That's mean Allah is not needed. So the God of Islam is obviously a Satan. What do you think, Firoz?
Actually, the most shocking thing is that we never learned this thing in our mosque. So, like, they only tell about good things, like what Muhammad did and what Allah does for us, and they never tell the other side of the story. They always push the positive side.
Yeah. So this is why we should not go, especially those Muslim YouTubers, they are a bunch of liars, as you see. And the truth is coming. Like even did that now. He's making fun of what is written in his book, not in our book. He's saying it's a shameful behavior to make your prophet walk naked when it's his God who made Moses walk naked. And the Bible did not say what he's saying. It's a shameful behavior to make a drink, to give a drink alcohol to someone who's dying because of his pain. But it's not a shameful behavior that his God is saying that wine next to big breast in heaven. And not only that, God is saying in the Quran, supposedly, that Allah, He made wine as a sign from Him and to make good provision, which means to drink from it and to make money from it. It's not a shameful behavior to have sex with the children, but it's a shameful behavior to give a drink for the one who's dying to ease his pain. This is how they switch the truth upside down. This is why we should be careful. Doesn't matter who we are, Christian, Muslims, Hindus, Jews. Anyone who says something to us, check it out, and you will find that those people, they are lying. There's no honesty on those statements. And then we will find that everything they say, it is actually in their book, not in our book. And this is why I say that Islam is like a whore. She worked as a porn star, and she claimed that she is virgin. But here, we take off the panty of Allah and we show everybody the private part of Allah, exposing His private part, which is nothing but the private part of the devil. Anything else you want to add, Firoz?
Yeah, nothing else. I just want to say that your way of teaching is, I must say that it is very very right. You should do this teaching. You should continue doing this because initially. Yeah, of course, initially we will like feel like you are hating us, you are mocking us, but as time goes by, we get to know the truth. So every day, like I used to search the truth, like, are you saying the truth or not? I used to watch the videos. I even called one of my imams and he told me that you cannot trust the websites and all, they are all, you know, spreading Islamophobia and you have to search it for yourself. No one will help you. Yeah.
See, this is an answer actually for those Christians who say they are very tough with the Muslims. As you see, my way is very effective, and maybe if I am not tough with Firoz, he will not leave Islam. Maybe if I am so easy, and you know, he will not leave Islam. But because I am tough, he says, and this is his opinion, he agreed that my way is very effective, and now here we go. He decided to leave the cult of Muhammad. Yeah, Firoz.
Yeah.
There is any churches close to your area? If there's any Christian churches close to your area?
Yeah, there is actually.
Okay, well, because you need to read the Bible now. You need to understand it, and you know it's better if you go and get baptized. Because when you get baptized, yeah, my friend, you will receive.
Yeah, I want to do that.
Yeah, baptized is very important. Baptized is very important because you are like, it's like, you know, it's not only it's not just ritual. It is literally you will receive a gift from God by being His child, by announcing yourself in front of the Lord that today I am your child. I wash myself from my sin before, from the cult I was following, from the pagan Muhammad, the black stone kisser, and today I am yours. So baptism is very important, and the Holy Spirit will fill your heart and will accompany you for the rest of your life.
Yes, yes, I will do it. But I have to, you know, also look after my life, because people know that who I am. They will, you know, try to harm me.
All right.
So I will do that. Yeah, I will for sure do that.
Well, let me know when you get baptized so we can have a little party for you here. Okay.
Yeah, sure. So I will let you know.
All right, my friend. So I can call you brother now. I'm not going to call you Firoz. You know, you drive me crazy, Firoz.
Actually, you are pronouncing my name wrong. It's Firoz, not Firoz.
How I say it? Sorry?
It is Firoz, not Firoz.
Firoz. Because in Arabic, you see, in Arabic, we use the name Firoz, so Firoz. Okay, Firoz, not Firoz. Firoz, okay. Firoz.
Firoz.
Firoz?
Firoz.
Oh, hold on.
Firoz.
Firoz.
Firoz. Firoz.
Firoz. Firoz.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, right.
Okay, Firoz. Okay, Firoz. Well, no problem, my friend. I will call you Peter. So the Lord, maybe He make you the rock in your home, and your home will be built in a very strong rock of faith, of belief, and to be a messenger for the Lord between your family and your tribe and your people, so you can bring them to Christ. All right?
Amen to that.
All right. Thank you, my friend. Thank you. Take care. God bless you.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Yeah, Firoz, you know, he used to drive me, like, I mean, I keep explaining to him. He called me liars. Each time, you know, he called me a liar. This is a lie. It's not true. You see the text? If you go in the videos in the previous month, I mean, this guy, anything I say, he say, it's a lie. You are a liar. Where do you get this from? It's not true. You know, and he get angry and he call me like he keep calling, and sometimes even I hang up on him. Sometimes I don't even take his call because it's became too much annoying, because I show it to him in the screen and still he say it's not true. It's in the screen. It's not true. Why? I understand. He told you it's hard. It's hard to believe that this is happening. All his life, believing in a man, he thought he is holy. All his life, believing in a God, he thought he is holy. And then suddenly you come to a person, his name is a Christian prince, and you are saying to me, my God is a piece of garbage? Proving it to me from my book? That's not right. That's not easy. However, thanks to the Lord, and thanks for the support of people here, we were able to help Firoz, and the Lord opened his eyes to leave the cult of Muhammad and to accept the Christ.